9.
Once the call went out, not only did law enforcement agencies roll into West Odessa, but a slew of businesses and Red Cross volunteers moved in as well. Sarah Snyder joins us with the story. Sarah.
Well, David, over 20 law enforcement agencies from all across the state and 150 officers came in to help Ector County deputies. Most of them worked around the clock. And while they worked, teams of volunteers from the American Red Cross and local restaurants came together, making sure those officers were taken care of.
Those guys and ladies had a tough job for a very long period of time.
A 22-hour standoff kept these officers on the scene constantly, working all night Friday and most of the day Saturday. And just a couple hours after the first call went out, the American Red Cross volunteers rushed in to help, taking food and water to the scene.
It is a team effort and very gratifying to be part of it. And I clearly was just an observer, but happy to do what we could do to help the cause.
Restaurants throughout Odessa, like Domino's Pizza, Pizza Hut, and Bush's Chicken, took food and drinks out to the university and Knox crime scene.
They're always grateful. Every time they come through, they're appreciative of the of us taking care of them, as we're appreciative of the job they do.
Teams of Red Cross volunteers loaded up their vehicles and set up camp right next to Victor White's property. During the course of the weekend, they served over 200 meals and handed out countless bottles of water. The director told us the total cost for the relief efforts ran about $1,500. Volunteers worked side by side with those first responders, staying right there with them until last night.
Oh, it was fascinating. Absolutely fascinating. To see the capability in terms of everything from helicopters to special vehicles to special communication systems to the night vision devices that are available, the high technology communications vans that are out there, state of the art.
And they're there for us day in, day out, putting their life on the line, and we should take care of them.
Tonight, the Red Cross says they need the community support after helping out this weekend. They're looking for donations and volunteers. If you want more information, visit our website, newswest9.com, and click on the news links. Live in the studio, Sarah Snyder, News West 9.